How's it going, guys? Dave here from Pixel Film Studios, getting ready to give you some awesome news. The latest version of Final Cut Pro has just come out, 10.4.9, and we're about to show you all the amazing features that it has to offer. Before updating Final Cut Pro, make sure your system requirements are up to par. To check these, navigate to the top left corner of your Mac screen and click on the Apple icon. And select About This Mac. First, confirm that you're on Mac OS 10.14.6, 10.15.6, or later. We are currently using Mac OS 11, known as Big Sur. And this is indeed compatible with the latest version of Final Cut Pro. For memory requirements, you must have at least 4 GB of RAM to use the updated version of Final Cut Pro. But at least 8 GB is recommended for 4K video editing, 3D rendering, and 360-degree video. You also want to make sure that your graphics card is metal compatible. An easy way to see if your graphics card is compatible is to click on System Report on the bottom of the window. This window will appear. In the list on the left, locate Graphics, Displays, and look for Metal. If it says Supported, your graphics card is good to go. At least 1 GB of video RAM is recommended for 4K video editing, 3D rendering, and 360-degree video in Final Cut. You can check how much you have in the same window, where it says VRAM. For example, we have 8 GB of VRAM. And last but not least, make sure you have at least 3.8 GB of space on your computer before you update. And if you meet all the system requirements like we just showed you, then you can use these new features. Now, without further ado, let's explore the new features in Final Cut Pro version 10.4.9. First, you will be able to generate proxy media in custom frame sizes. To do this, hold Ctrl and click on the clip in the browser that does not have proxy media generated yet. Select Transcode Media, and in the window that appears, in the frame size dropdown, we can choose from 12.5% of the original size, to the same size, or 100% of the original. The smaller the frame rate, the smaller the proxy media file size will be. Just above that, we can create proxy media in ProRes Proxy or H.264 formats. You probably already know about H.264, but ProRes Proxy is intended for use in offline workflows that require low data rates but full resolution video. So we can choose between the two based on your preferences. If proxy media is not available for certain clips, they can display the optimized or original version instead. The option will be located in the top of the viewer. Choose View, and under Media Playback, choose this new option, Proxy Preferred. Now any clips that have proxy will play in proxy, and any clips that do not have proxy media will play in optimized or original quality. This gives much more flexibility when choosing which clips you want to have proxy and which are optimized. Along those same lines, we can also now create a proxy-only copy of our library. To do this, we'll navigate to our library sidebar, hold Ctrl, and click on the library name. In the menu, we can select Copy to Library, and we'll choose New Library. We'll give our proxy library a name and click Save. In this brand new menu, we can choose which types of media we want to copy to the new library. And if we deselect everything except proxy, we can create a proxy library that reduces file size, making the library easier to transfer. This is great if you need to take your library on your travels to edit on something compact, like a laptop. And once you've finished, you can copy your edited project from the Proxy Media Library back to your main library without any media and resume working. Be aware that if you select proxy and some of your clips do not have generated proxy files, you will get this error. To avoid this, be sure to transcode all your media and generate proxy files. If you want to learn more about transcoding media, check out our tutorial linked in the description below. You can now use something called Smart Conform to transform your clips for your project. To do this, navigate to the top menu, hover over Modify, and choose Smart Conform. After a moment, it will conform your clip to the resolution of your project. This can be especially helpful for conforming your clips to vertical or square formats for social media like TikTok or Instagram. We'll select the clip, then navigate up to the top menu, hover over Modify, and select Smart Conform. The on-screen controls in the viewer will allow us to align our clip properly. And when it's finished, we'll select Done. The same can be done if we have a square project. Simply select Smart Conform, and then select Done. This next feature will allow you to put custom overlays over your viewer. Now, why is that good? Maybe the horizon's not cutting it for you and you need a grid so you can see if things line up vertically, horizontally, all throughout your screen. So to add the custom overlay, we'll navigate to the top right of the viewer, select View, and under Overlays, we'll click on Choose Custom Overlay. To load your custom overlay, choose Add Custom Overlay, and you'll be able to load in any image file. We'll load in this PNG that we made of a grid. Then select Open. We already uploaded the grid, so we'll just go ahead and click Replace to re-upload it. We can see it in the viewer, and if we choose View again, we can choose from different opacities. At 100% opacity, the grid will be completely visible. But if we choose 25% opacity, the image is barely visible, so we can see both the footage and the overlay. Using this grid, we can see that our objects are lining up pretty well within the grid lines. So we've confirmed that there is no lens distortion or warping going on in our footage. Keep in mind that the overlay will not be exported with your project. If for some reason you want it to be a part of your project, you'll need to import the overlay image onto the project as a regular image clip. This next feature is called the Transform Overscan control. This allows you to see what's outside the viewer and what you're missing. You can activate the overscan controls by clicking on this button in the upper right corner of the viewer. Being able to see what's beyond the boundaries of the viewer makes a huge difference when transforming footage. If you want to learn more about how to transform your video, check out our tutorial linked in the description below. Now there's a brand new way to duplicate your projects, and here is why it's cool. In the top menu, we'll select Edit. You will see a new Duplicate Project As command. You'll also notice that Duplicate Project as a Snapshot has been changed to Snapshot Project, which works the same exact way. Check out our tutorial linked in the description below to find out more about duplicate options. When we select Duplicate Project As, this will open a project settings window before duplicating our project. This differs from Duplicate Project command, which doesn't open the project settings window. Notice too that Smart Conform is included in this project settings menu. If you have ProRes RAW footage, you can now access new camera settings controls in the inspector, including ISO, color temperature, and exposure. And now there's a brand new way to crossfade your audio in Final Cut. Check it out. There is a new keyboard shortcut for crossfading audio on adjacent audio clips. simply select two adjacent audio clips. Then navigate up to the top menu, hover over Modify, Adjust Audio Fades, and choose Crossfade, or use the shortcut Option T. This window may pop up if we don't have enough media to create the crossfade. We'll go ahead and confirm. And if we zoom in, after we expand the audio, we can see how Final Cut Pro generated this crossfade. The new drop-down menu above the timeline allows you to clear your project history by choosing Close Project. You can also duplicate a project. Reveal a project in the browser. Check your project's properties. And close other timelines. Check out our other tutorials linked in the description below for more information about these commands. In List View, you can sort clips and projects by the date they were last modified. So in this header, we'll hold Ctrl and click, then choose Last Modified to check on it. Then, scroll to the right, and Last Modified will display the date that each clip or project was most recently modified. And we can click on the Last Modified header to sort the clips by that value. This next feature deals mostly with 360 video. A little bit of a novelty thing, but we're going to show you anyway. The first change is that we can preview 360-degree video in a bunch of new views. To do this, we simply need to navigate to the View menu and select 360-degree Viewer, or use the shortcut Option-Command-7. When editing stereoscopic footage, these views will be available to you. And finally, we can stabilize 360-degree video with one click in the inspector. Simply navigate down to Stabilize and check on it. There's a couple more changes dealing with XML, and you can read about those in the official update. One major concern with this update is that if you're using a third-party Red RAW or Canon RAW plugins for your Red or Canon footage, they are not yet compatible with this update for Final Cut Pro. And that's it for the latest version of Final Cut 10.4.9 and all the features that come with it. Don't forget to check out Pixel Film Studios, where you can find Final Cut Pro plugins designed for beginners and professionals alike to take your projects to the next level.